Hi everyone, Grant Kay here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. I was recently asked a question about exporting files with embedded alpha from Flame Premium or Smoke Advanced. How do I set up the exported files to have either straight alpha or premultiplied alpha? Well, the answer has to do with the comp timeline effects tool and how it affects a matte container. For previous versions of Flame Premium and Smoke Advanced, you had to keep a separate RGB clip and a separate alpha matte clip. Upon setting up an export, you would select the fill followed by the alpha. This only allowed for a single clip export with an embedded alpha and minimal control over the alpha settings. The export workflow has changed considerably in the current releases of Flame Premium and Smoke Advanced. The timeline now supports full RGBA, and a few things were done to support multi-file export with an embedded alpha channel. So to make this clear for you, I am going to start on a reel with a separate RGB fill clip and its corresponding alpha clip. These clips could have originated from batch, BFX, or even the timeline, but don't worry about it at this point. Now, the first thing to know about exporting files with embedded alpha is that the RGB fill and alpha always have to be in a matte container. Essentially, the matte container is exported to create your media. So to create a matte container from these clips, you can do it in two ways. If you prefer using the timeline, you can be in the timeline view and select your RGB fill clip. In the mini toolbar, you will see an option to add a matte to the segment. So choosing that option and picking the matte clip will turn the segment into a matte container which contains the RGB fill and the alpha. Having a look at the player, you will see the result of the fill combined with the alpha. Now, depending whether the original sources were unpremultiplied or premultiplied with the alpha, you would set the segment setting in the Comp Timeline Effects tool. In my case, the fill was an unpremultiplied source, and that is the setting I'll choose. Please remember that what you see in the player is actually exported. This is very important to remember. If this does not look correct, then your export will be incorrect. So that is how you create a matte container via the timeline. If you prefer using the Tools view, which is a more traditional Flame Premium approach, you will find the option in the Utilities tab. So click Create Matte Container. The parameters are set to create a matte container, as well as enable the comp timeline effects that you saw earlier. So click the RGB fill, the alpha, and click on the reel to create the matte container clip. As before, looking at the player, you will see the result of the comp tool being applied to the matte container. Looking at it in the timeline view, you can set the interpretation settings for the alpha in the segment. Now, if I flick between both of the clips, you can see the end result is the same. What I can tell you is that if I exported both matte container clips, you would get two file sequences with pre-multiplied alpha. So how do you choose between a straight or pre-multiplied alpha export? To make this clear, I'll just press N to rename one clip to straight. I'll also rename the other clip and call it pre-multiply. Looking at the pre-multiply clip first, you will see that the comp timeline effects is enabled. So the timeline is already multiplying the RGB by the matte. Exporting this will give you a fill multiplied by its alpha. So let's move over to the matte container that we want to export with an unpremultiplied or straight alpha. This time, turn the comp timeline effects off. All you should see is just the RGB fill and not the matte. By exporting with comp off, the matte container will not multiply the alpha against the fill, and you will get an exported sequence with a straight alpha. So to conclude, I'll control swipe to bring up the media panel. Switching to the media hub, I'll navigate to my export folder within the file browser. All that remains is to multi-select the map containers and drag them into the file browser. In the export settings, you can choose a format that supports embedded alpha. I'll choose the 16-bit TIFF preset and export the sequences. The files export in the background, and once the export is complete, you can refresh the folder to see the sequences. If I open up the pre-multiply sequence, you can see that the RGB fill is already pre-multiplied by the alpha. And if I open up the straight sequence, the RGB fill was not multiplied by the alpha. So here are the 3 points to remember. You need a matte container to export a file with an embedded alpha. You need to set the alpha correctly in the comp timeline effects and look at what you see in the player. And finally, having comp on will produce a pre-multiplied alpha, and comp off will produce an unpre-multiplied or straight alpha embedded in your exported media. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning channel for future videos.